Hi, we're here in Hartlepool talking to the lovely Amanda's cats. Hi, Amanda.
Hi.
Do you want to tell us a bit about yourself, your art practice, and what you do?
Okay. I think currently at this moment in time, I'm kind of feeling around in the area of illustration, really. Analog, i.e. traditional and digital. But my background has been community arts and arts education, and I've been at the Northern School of Art for about 20 years, nearly 18 years, yeah. And over the last 5 years, I've been trying to make work that's about more about what I want to do, rather than enabling other people to make art. So that's a bit of a change for me.
Fantastic. How did you first get involved with the arts?
I would probably say, I don't know, probably at school, really. School teachers, someone in primary, somebody in secondary. I went to do A-levels and the art college degree. My degree's actually in film and TV, but I've never touched a film camera since. But I fell in love with the media, the discipline called community art, which I'd never heard of until I went to university. That's kind of stayed with me and has kind of informed everything I've done really up to this point.
So who would you say were your major inspirations in the work that you do now or in the past?
I think that's really difficult because I think I was fortunate to work in an art gallery for, I don't know, 6-7 years. And I worked alongside a lot of other artists. They might be coming in to show work or do workshops. So I got to meet a lot of people in the flesh, which was lovely. But I've got like a lot of visual creative people, got a visual memory, and I can still remember individual pages out of books that I had as a, you know, quite a small child. So I think even though I could give you some huge big names, I think my love lies in children's illustrations, really, colour, pattern. I love surface design. I love graffiti and graphics and all that kind of thing. And I've always liked painting large scale things. So, yeah, eclectic.
Yeah.
Genuinely people that I meet, but in this digital era, you can spend hours in Pinterest.
Yeah. So you've talked about you've had a formal education. Do you think a lot of it has been self-taught as well? Is it kind of down to you getting down to the nitty-gritty and kind of learning a skill and then getting more education to kind of back that up? Or how would you say that you've been taught?
I think kind of having an arts background gives you the kind of formal building bricks, which sometimes can be a little bit restricting. Being out there in the real world and meeting other artists has helped an awful lot. One of my major influences was a nice man in the early 90s who told me as a woman I could never use Adobe Photoshop. So that kind of rankled a little bit. I'm very self-taught digitally. I have been on a few workshops where I picked up new skills, but most of it is trial and error. And obviously working in education, I'm surrounded by people, so I'm always trying new things. But I think that you need to have that kind of attitude where you're just going to try and just experiment and keep practicing and keep working at something that you're really interested in. So I think it's great to have a formal education, but I also think it's really important to develop your own skills, you know, constantly just doing things that you've never tried before just because you fancy it and you like it.
So would you say you worked on your own or do you collaborate a lot?
I think when I first started doing work just purely for myself, it was it was just me really in my studio, bouncing ideas off some friends, family. But as I've gained more confidence in what I'm doing as a person rather than enabling others is that, yeah, collaboration's fantastic, especially with the right people. It's supportive. So what have I done? I have worked with a goldsmith, upholsterer. I've worked with amazing community people in the local vicinity. I've just been today spray painting with a landscape architect, so in a primary school. So yeah, collaborations are fab.
Fantastic. And so why do you think creative arts are important personally and more generally socially?
I think we're all born creative and we're all still creative, but we can develop it. And that doesn't mean to say that I want everybody to do art and become an artist. It's just that when you're problem solving, when you're working, the creative brain can help you so much. So yeah, I'm not necessarily talking about everybody needs to be fantastic with a pencil, but just genuinely having ideas. I think that's good for the whole society. I think people being in and around arts is fantastic. Just a recent project that I've been in involved with yourselves, where the communities all came together to create something. The buzz, the excitement is fantastic. On a more soulful level, just the pure enjoyment of making something, creating something. It doesn't have to be something fantastic. For me, it's often a pack of felt tips and a doodle that can satisfy me. Creativity is a way to look at the world. I want to live in a world where we celebrate people and their cultures and we want to be happy, rather than chasing other goals. I think if we've got a happy society, then we're going to have a happy world and we can make better decisions. So I kind of think creativity, the world, the environment, animals, a more organic approaches, even though I work digitally, is the way to go.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. So how has lockdown affected you and your work? Plans? What have you, like, has it affected your future goals or plans? Has anything changed?
Initially, it's been up and down, to be honest, because initially I had 2 weeks off and I did quite a few training courses online with different techniques, got quite excited about things. Then I realised that some of the places where I sell my work were shut. A lot of marketplaces weren't available. But then because we have social media, I was still getting people asking for work. I was still completing work, been working on an album cover. So a lot of things can still be done despite COVID. But the kind of touchy-feely wanting to be with other people creating stuff is slightly harder. Just a project that I was involved with yourselves with Blooming Arts, we ended up working on a project which involved local communities, in social distancing ways. And that was a new way. We've worked with community on projects before with yourselves, but this one was special. The excitement of people coming outside to get involved was lovely. So there's downsides, upsides, and also new ways of thinking about how you're going to work. That's what creative brain should be doing, is thinking about, right, how can we do things? How can we keep improving things? We might not be working in the same way, but which other ways can we work?
Yeah, fantastic. Well, it's been lovely to speak to you, Amanda. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.